Boy.
It's some kind of drawing. Maybe a map? Oh! Maybe a treasure map! We'll need something to get through this one. see something up there. Up there. Bet I could reach that with some help. Look up there! Almost there! I can't jump over with those wooden boards in the way. It is! It's another one of those sand bowls. There are different ruins written along the side of this one.
What does it say?
Another riddle. Feed me not, we both are doomed. Overfeed me, all consume.
The answer might be near, like the other.
The answer's gotta be written around here somewhere, right? It says fire. Of course. Bow. Wait for me. Yep. Hey, this does more than decipher those Muspelheim runes. It also contains the travel rune. Should we go visit the fire rune? There should be one more. Turn back AC. Guess the gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vinder. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above. Ah, wind. Vinder. Look what it did! Father, she is here. It's so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hemelin! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the Witch in the Woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either. Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
Now!
You're welcome!
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to it?
Indeed. It speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spit in your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
How do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Got time for a favor?
Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why, you... He knows the pain of your loss. He will help you. Curious.
What is it?
Oh, nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're headed in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
Is that one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look!
The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
I can read what this says now, but it's a name.
Air! Whoa!
The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Get to the boat. We can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Nightmares! Ugh! What awful pests!
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won. but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Come and face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the God Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. He quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I came off of that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
Oh, yeah. That's the answer.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous obstacle to the south.
Focus up! Look here.
Yes, sir. Hey, it's another treasure map. The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Fjorgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Fjorgun was gone, lonely ages passed. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later.
Focus up, boy.
Tough fight.
Got time for a favor?
What'll it be? Later then. Now you're talking. Say the word, kid. You think what you want? Sure, that'll keep you out of trouble. Gotta keep them from packing bits off you.
So, you sticking around for grains of wisdom?
Look here.
Sir. Vaithargar, southern outpost of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
I'd heard rumors of a powerful dwarf ruling over some poor sods not far from here. Not that you asked me.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways.
Watch your right!
If it's okay by now!
Look here.
Yes, sir. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused. Read it.
Yes, sir. Vaithardauther. It means hunting death. Great. Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. That sounds like a dragon. There's a Thor statue on that island. That must be where the spirit's father is buried.
Follow me, Atreus.
On my way.
It is a dragon. Is this one chained up too?
Look here.
Sir. Hold on. Let me read this. Watch out for the dragon breath.
I am aware of it, boy.
Stories. Can we help him?
This dragon is dangerous.
I guess so. But it sounds so sad.
Jump! Be ready!
Follow me, Atreus.
Huh!
destroy the other ones.
If it was your mother's wish.
Yeah.
You are too eager, boy. It may attack us, and we will be forced to kill it.
Oh, good point. I'll be ready.
You will see. Thank you.
believe, or to have faith in. So they still had faith in their king? Even after he got so many of them killed?
It is a command to have faith despite his failures.
Dwarf built it? They must have been impressive back when he ruled.
Find out if dragons can be grateful or not.
Boy, prepare yourself. Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted.
Whoa, here it is. It's gotta have a weak point. Somewhere.
That one, brother.
His father's grave. Find anything good?
Perhaps.
Father, we're going to bring down that statue, right?
We're really just going to loot his grave and leave? So what was it like when Odin and Freya got married?
He granted us so many wishes I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned.
What? Tell this one later.
Doing this himself.
Do not fall this easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Father, why did the gods cause so much trouble for us?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Odin and Freya's marriage wasn't that bad?
Aye, for a while it truly wasn't.
But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Got time for a favor?
Come on in, then. So much for peace and quiet. Another time, then.
What is it, dwarf?
There's this alchemist on Vari. Been working out in the Velander mine. You haven't heard from him in maybe, I don't know, 100 winters or so. Probably dead, but maybe you can find him. He's dwarfing like me, wears a fancy green ring. Owes me a favor. You look?
If it is on our path.
Oh, I see how it is.
Hey, Brock. You found something interesting.
Did you now? Well, color me interested.
Did you hear that too? Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Or I can just tell you this story later.
Frey ended up living in the woods.
She'd finally reached her limit with Odin and broke things off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities and exploited them to craft curses she could never break. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Atreus, to me!
Okay, so Freya left, and Odin was mad.
Furious. And he cursed her most terribly.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face, too.
Aye, lad. So would I. You gentlemen certainly know how to get around. Why don't you tell me how all this began with Baldur?
He just knocked on our door.
Baldur of Asgard just knocked on your door?
Yeah, he just showed up and started a fight. He said he wanted to know something. He said, I know what you are.
Oh, well, we'll circle back to that later. What exactly did he want to know?
I was under the floor, by
the way. He said I already knew what he wanted. Perhaps he mistook me for another.
That's quite interesting.
Could you take a look at this?
What you got for old Brock? What'll it be, Shorty? There ain't nobody's twisting your arm.